So a few days ago, you couldn't hardly approach this horse's hind feet there. And now she's let us pick up and we've cleaned her feet before we got started here this morning. But I'm just gonna get her set them down there nice and quiet. Okay. So just let her kind of settle there with it for a little bit. Free, with a soft face. Whereas the first few times we saddled her, she thought about kind of bowing down there a little bit. So that's a good sign. Just kind of move her hip off, change directions with her. Try to keep her quiet here. Hip, shoulders. Now we just kind of cut her loose and just let her travel a little bit. Ask her to come to us here. Very good. See if we can get a direction change out of her here. Try to keep her mind quiet here. Give her a jump to me. She starts to get herself wound up. Very good. Let her lope off this way just a little bit. Call for it. Very good. I'm just going to test out and see if she's coming along with her little four-quarter drill. Going to ask for the hip. Ask for the shoulders, so she can step on around for me here. Without me getting my hand up in her face all the time. Come forward, give me some hip, give me some shoulder. There we go. There we go. So, we've already tested out, she's pretty darn good at wanting to follow the weight of the rein. And we've done this with her just a couple of times. We want her to start to surrender to that rope when it goes up behind her here and just follow her nose out like that. Okay, Luke. Set that rein. Right there. She's thinking already. There. Good. And just remind her of the stuff. So a few days ago, we just kind of taught her that when I go to put something in your mouth, I'd like for you to come over here, just kind of help her, and I'll take that out, okay? So today I'll just kind of introduce this bit to her, and just, if you'll take it nice and sweet, and then just, if you'll come over here, all on your own, to lower your head, here I'll let you spit it out, good girl. And then my goal would be that she'd come over here and ask for it just like that, see? Just tell her how smart she is for taking it. Okay, so then again, we like the ring of the halter and the snaffle before we just start asking for snaffle pressure on her. So we'll just kind of set that rein there on the outside just a little. Kind of let her find herself there. When she tugs to the outside, she can hit the end of this rein. Yeah, just let her find it. There you go. There you go. Carrying her head nice and pretty and soft there. Good. A few days ago, I couldn't even hardly get down here to her hind legs. Today she's letting us put these boots on. Very little apprehension. So we go ahead and feed the rein in through the stirrup from behind. Again, we hook into the halter and then the bit. Okay. We know she's pretty good at following her nose. I just want her to kind of feel this rope. Get moved around a little bit. And touch on her a little. Without scaring her. Courage to turn right off the left rein. Turn, 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 turn. Encourage her to follow her nose. Uh-oh. Okay. So we kind of get her moving along here now. Pick up on the right rein. Encourage her to move off the left. Just move forward. I don't care if she just walks. And keep encouraging her to move forward here. There we go. To move, turn her back. Turn her back to the left there. There you go. Keep her going left. Ask her to go, kind of ask her to turn right. Very nice. Ask her to turn left. Very nice. Good girl. Ask her to turn right. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Good girl. Turn left. Got a pretty good left turn. Not so good on the right turn. Move on. Ask her here, turn right. Very good. And then ooh. And just kind of let her take a break there. Me too.